Hi, I'm Odin, a Build.com project expert. Welcome to our FAQ series, Glad You Asked. Today's question is, how do I choose track lighting? Track lighting is very versatile and can be customized for any space. It's great for illuminating an entire room or spotlighting wall art or architectural details. So how does it work? Let's head into the Build.com kitchen set to find out. Track lighting works by attaching light sources, also called luminaries, to a track or rail. These light sources can either be track heads or track pendants. In this video, we'll just use the term track heads to mean any style of luminary. Electricity passes through the track and into the heads to power the lights. The track heads can be moved along the track and swiveled or tilted to direct light exactly where you need it. There are three standard types of tracks, and the shape of the track head connector has to match the shape of the track. Track heads usually pull 12 or 24 volts. Since the electrical current in your home is 120 volts, the power is going to need to be stepped down. Depending on the type of track you choose, the transformer to step down the power from 120 volts will either be part of the rail or built into each individual track head. One of the advantages of a track lighting system is the ability to easily swap out track heads. Just be aware though that not all track heads fit on all rails. There are countless combinations of shapes, styles, and finishes, so you can change up your look just by taking the old heads out and clipping new ones onto the track. In this modern design, we chose a sleek, minimalist track head with a brushed brass finish. Now let's take a look at the three types of track lighting: track, rail, and cable. Linear track lighting is the most traditional type. The track is mounted directly to a surface, usually the ceiling, but in this kitchen, we mounted the tracks to the sides of this beam. An electrical conduit runs inside the entire length of the track. You can place the track heads anywhere along the track. When the metal base comes in contact with the conduit in the track, it gets the power it needs to illuminate the light. A transformer is built into each track head, so you don't need a separate transformer to step down the power to your system. Monorail lighting hangs down from the ceiling, suspended by rods called standoffs. Unlike traditional track lighting, monorails are flexible and can be bent and curved. The electrical current runs through the exposed metal of the rail itself. The heads are attached to the outside of the track, making the connection necessary to power the lights. The heads can be repositioned along the rail and swapped out when your style changes. Most monorail systems are low voltage and will require a transformer. In cable light systems, the electricity runs through low voltage conductive cables. The cables are suspended from the ceiling or stretched from wall to wall. Track heads or pendants are then attached to the cables. The heads typically require 12 or 24 volts, so cable lighting systems will need a transformer to step down the standard 120 volt household current. Finally, there's fixed rail lighting, which is a subcategory of rail lighting which has the lamps fixed directly to the track. In most cases, the heads can be tilted or swiveled, but you can't switch them for another style, and they can't move along the rail. Everything you need for your new track lighting system can be found at build.com. And if you have any questions, please give us a call. We can help you find exactly what you need for your project. And for more great tips on choosing the perfect track lighting for any space, check out our buying guide by clicking the link below. If you found this video helpful, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe to our channel. And tune in next week when we answer a new question on Glad You Asked. Thanks for watching.